continuing lockdown, each of us are learning to cope, to accommodate, to build capacity and competence in facing this crisis. This is an unprecedented crisis. If mankind had seen something like this before, we might have built tools, we might have built techniques, we might have built methods, we might have built the leadership necessary to face it. But this is something new to all of us. This is beyond the repertoire of tools that we already have. So it's necessary that we feel challenged. And in this challenge, the real situation is how do we expand our skill sets? How do we expand our competence and necessarily meet it? This is going to be the leadership challenge for us at a personal level. Now, public leadership has got a lot of technical tools to handle the crisis. Now, it might be epidemiological tools. It might be tools to discover vaccines, to discover medicines. Those are straightforward and known. But what is not known is to handle the uncertainty that comes from the severe lockdown, to handle the insecurity that our migrant laborers face, to handle the challenges of everyday existence that people who don't have the money because they're daily wage earners and what the problems that they're facing, to constantly understand that we need to reassure our people, our friends, our relatives, that everything might be okay. Because nobody knows how this crisis is going to pan out. And this is where we now need to build those additional skill sets. Some of us might struggle in everyday life to even reach out and talk to people. We now need to build a new skill set. How do we be more social? How do we reach out to our neighbors? How do we talk to others? So leadership truly is now learning to understand how do we start operating from the zones of our incompetence. Because only when you feel incompetent, then you'll have the humility to understand that you need to acquire that competence. And in that search for that competence, you learn. And this kind of learning is also leadership. A constant desire to keep learning, to build on your set of competences, to meet the new challenges that are going to emerge. So let's now, together, learn how to do it. We might do it by reading new books. We might do it by intense thinking. We might do it by acquiring online tools from the internet. We might do certain courses that we think we always wanted to do to understand and build our leadership skills. Or we can take it one step further and try to run small experiments. Experiments of reaching out, picking up the phone, calling up 10 people each day. Five people we know distantly. We can reach out to relatives we never spoke to in the past. We can learn now to build the tool of forgiveness. People whom we didn't agree with in the past, people with whom we have disagreements. Can we now pick up the phone, expand our social skills and tell them and ask them how they are doing? Just reaching out, demonstrating compassion itself could be a new skill that we can learn. Let's try it out and keep this journey of personal leadership going.